Thank you for tuning in and listening to this song. I do have the tabs handwritten out on my guitarjourney.tripod.com website. And I'm going to spend a little bit of time here and break it down to show you how I fingerpick this. So let's go at it. We start with the G and the C back and forth. Basically, I'm following the melody there. And then I go into the next part of B minor 7. Sometimes life can spin out of control. This might be spinning too fast. Okay. So now into the next part, a little walk up there, C, C sharp to D. That's that part. I'm a little dizzy. I'm a little dizzy, so dizzy. It'll help me hang on to this crazy ride. Okay, so what we have there is a D7 with a flat 9, and I'm even playing the 9th natural there against the flat nine. You've heard that before. But anyway, I'm playing both of them in there. So there's your D9, there's your D-flat 9, D7 flat 9. Okay. And with the opening, which would be the natural 9. So I'm using alternate bass in there too. Kind of a Chet Atkins feel there. Let's see. See the bass? And I'm just saying and singing, I'm a little dizzy, so dizzy, and it kind of sounds dizzy. I'm a little dizzy, so dizzy, oh help me hang on to this crazy ride. I'm just so damn busy. I'm just so damn busy, so busy, oh help me hang on to this wild ride. Now it's really crazy, so crazy, so creepy. Let me try it again. Now it's really crazy, so crazy, it can't be. The whole damn world is wrong, you know. Gotta take it easy, so easy. Bend up, G, okay. So let's try this again, backing up to this part. This is the funnest part. And where I got this little bit, the idea for it, is from an arrangement that Chet Atkins did of Arkansas Traveler. And just the little bit in Arkansas Traveler went like this. Let's see if I remember it. Okay, that's it. That was the first time I realized that that sound was coming from, you know, I thought. And I just started messing around with it. So when I come up with this song, Life is a Merry-Go-Round, I use that. So you never know when you're learning a piece, what little bit in there can inspire you to create your own music. So that's the neat thing. It's very beneficial to learn these finger-picking patterns and these riffs and these chords and all of this meshed together, because you never know where it's going to take you. That's the exciting thing about all of this. So now when I do this, I'm a little dizzy, so dizzy, you help me hang on. I'm just so damn busy, so busy, oh help me hang on to this wild ride. Then I go up a whole step. Now it's really crazy, so crazy, it can't be. The whole damn world is wrong, you know. Gotta take it easy, so please me right. D7 turns around, goes back to the beginning. So that's how you do that. This E7 flat 9 with an alternate bass. Now you got. Let's try that again. There it is. I'm a little dizzy, so dizzy, you'll help me. Okay, this is A9, A7, A7. And then into D7, or D7, there with the E is a D9. I decided to keep the D7 and D9 kind of straight at the end of that, because that would have been just a little bit too much tension there. So I'm bringing it down. so it sounds just fine there. So on and so forth. So I hope you like that little song there, and there's a lot of little things that you can take with you on that, and so just check out the tabs and have fun with it.